Good morning, children. This chapter, The Sound of Music, we're going to revise today. Yesterday, we revised first chapter of Beehive. Today, we are going to do second chapter, which is included in term one, okay? So make sure you know the syllabus. Fine, so before writing the value points and before giving you the reminder of the theme and everything, aap idhar aa jao, please. और पीछे चले जाओ कहीं और वो फैन के नीचे बैठना उधर बैठ जाओ ओनली 10 टू 12 स्टूडेंट्स दे सेंट मी देयर नोटबुक फॉर फाइनल चेकिंग एंड दे रिसीव्ड इट बैक आल्सो मेक श्योर आई हैव चेक्ड एंड सेंट ऑल द नोटबुक्स बैक इफ यू हैव नॉट रिसीव्ड यू कैन टेक्स्ट मी एंड द ग्रुप इज क्रिएटेड फॉर द पर्पस ओनली क्लियर सेंड योर notebooks over there in that notebooks group so that there are so many students and sometimes we miss it also and beta I have given you already time enough today is last day to submit your notebook for checking so those who won't be sending I won't be accepting after 20th make sure you have completed your work also so before we start writing the value points the sound of music let me introduce again so this chapter Yes, beta, am I audible to you all? There is some connectivity problem. Now, are you able to listen to me, beta? Am I audible now? Okay, fine, Raghav, thank you. So this chapter, The Sound of Music, is about Evelyn Glennie, the protagonist, and how she was facing a disability, or you can say, when she lost her hearing ability at the age of 8 only, and she did not let that disability hinder into her growth. She learned more than a normal human being can learn, fine? She could play 1,000 instruments just by feeling it, feeling the vibration and rhythm only. A normal human being can, you know, see and touch and feel and listen, but she was not able to hear. Even then, she could play thousands of instruments. Clear? So we are going to read, or you can say revise, this motivational story of about the life of Evelyn Glennie. So let's write down the points. So, beta, in objective questions, your motive is on MCQs. So, you should know all the facts. That's why I'm making you write the value points so that you remember. First point is, Evelyn Glennie was 8. Fine. So you can get at what age Evelyn Glennie lost her hearing ability. 8, 9, 10, 7. So you can get confused. Those who are attentive listeners, they will be knowing it. Clear? So at the age of 8, when her hearing disability was noticed first time by her mother. When her mother, who noticed it? Her mother. When her mother noticed her hearing disability, that she was not able to listen properly. Clear? And this is the age when her mother felt that my daughter is not able to listen. At what age the school discovered? Yes, 11. So at the age of 11, at the age of 11, school, her school also discovered this. Fine, discovered this here means discovered this disability. school authorities got to know when teacher was calling her name and she was not responding. So then they realized that she has some problem with her hearing. Clear? So after that, next point is, fortunately, Evelyn Glennie, she met Ron Fogg, the percussionist who identified her potential and supported her in achieving her goal. Always there are people who help you in uplifting you. Fine, whether you are having disability or not, but some people are there. God, if he has given you some disability or problem in life, solution also comes along with it. Fine. So very important character. The way I highlight the characters, first character, protagonist is. Fine. Now we are going to talk about R-O-N. Ron Forbes, F-O-R-B-E-S. This is the another important character. So fortunately, Ron Forbes, the percussionist. What do you mean by the word percussionist? You remember? The person who, you can say, is capable of multiple things at a time. Ron Forbes was able to play thousands of hundreds of instruments. So he was known as percussionist. Clear? And Ron Forbes fortunately noticed the capability or talent of. Yes, Dharia, my voice is lacking. Yes, Dharia.
Ma'am, aapki voice lag kar rahi, ma'am. Ma'am, board pe clear nahi aa raha.
Board clear nahi hai.
Network issue hai.
Okay, fine. So what should I do then? Yes, it is written your network connection is unstable. What can I do here? I can just check the wiring of my mic. Why board is not clear to you all? Let me check this. Now, beta, is it clear? Is it clear now, my voice? I removed the mask. Yes, Dharia.
Ma'am, वो network issue आ रहा है, ma'am इसलिए board blur कर देते हैं, ma'am hotspot से आप connect कर लो Wi-Fi.
Wait. That will take time then. Now it is not showing the message, beta. Are you able to listen to me now? Jia, Jaydev, Havish, rest of the students, kindly give your feedback. Yes, they are saying yes. Now it is clear, beta. So I need not disconnect. So jaldi se sun lo, ye na disconnect ho jaye dobara se. Okay? Now I have removed the mask because children are sitting away from me. Ron Forbes, the percussionist, he noticed the talent of Evelyn. So he was the one who noticed that this girl is full of talent. She has the capability. She has the ability. Fine. So finally, he took up the responsibility. He trained Evelyn to sense the music. What did Ron Forbes do? He trained Evelyn to feel the music. People teach to, you know, speak or sing or the different tals and instruments and all. But those children who still are facing some problem, they can leave the meeting and rejoin, okay? Because rest of the students are able to listen. So I won't end the meeting. He trained Evelyn to feel the music. क्लियर. सो दिस इज द टर्निंग पॉइंट इन लाइफ ऑफ एवलिन व्हेन शी गॉट अ गुड ट्रेनर, अ गुड पर्सन, अ गुड गुरु, वन गाइड ऑल्सो. क्लियर. सो आफ्टर दिस शी नेवर लुक्ड बैक. I'm not going to write this one. I'm just discussing with you all. Clear? So when she got a guru, a true guide, then she never looked back. She kept on moving forward in life only. Fine? So write down the facts now. Evelyn joined the famous Royal Academy of Music. Evelyn joined. You should know all the facts about this girl. Evelyn joined Royal Academy of Music. Yes, some students are joining again. Good. Now, is it clear? Now, am I audible to you all, those who have joined now? Send me your feedback, children. Are you able to listen to me? Yes, fine. So, yes, so Evelyn joined Royal Academy of Music. Fine. Next point, write down. In 1991, I'm talking about this year. In 1991, she bagged the Royal Philharmonic Society's prestigious award, Soloist of the Year. I'll be writing this because you want people to understand. Soloist of the Year. Solo means a single. In 1991, she bagged. What do you mean by bagged? That means she got, she received. Fine. She bagged an award, or you can say this is very prestigious award, Soloist of the Year award. Soloist. Solo likhi IST. Of the Year. Means in 1991 she received this. It is very prestigious award. Clear? And by which society it was given? By Royal Philharmonic Society. By Royal Philharmonic Society. Clear? So you should know the name. Which society gave him this prestigious award? Then after, you know, bagging this prestigious award, she had more interest in learning. Fine. And what did she do? She joined a group of people and she started going around the tours. You might have heard that singers go and musicians go for the world tour and all, and in different countries and cities. Soumya is thinking I will also go. Fine. So she sings well in our class, so that's why she's going into the dream. Then we have more singers also and music instrument players. Rishman is there. Fine. She bagged Soloist of the Year award by Royal Philharmonic Society. And then she never looked back after this. And she toured the world. T-O-U-R-E-D. She toured the world. Why did she tour the world? For her concerts and whatever work she was getting. For her concerts, because she was able to play thousands of instruments, so she was part of the group. For her concert. So she became very famous. People started knowing her. That girl who is not able to hear, hearing disability she is having, but even then she plays thousands of instruments. Then Evelyn soon became a shining star. She became quite famous, just like fine. And now the thing is, when people they gain success in their lives, there is a brighter chance that they will change also. They start having arrogance that yes, I'm the star of the day and star of among the masses, and people know me and I should behave like this. But this girl, she was having very philanthropic nature, kind nature to serve the society. The way she had, you know, gone through the difficulties in life, she wanted others not to feel the same. Clear? So she gave free concerts in prisons and hospitals. She organized free concerts in prisons, जो jail होती है, and hospitals. Because people they are stuck at a place and they feel dejected, so that's why she decided that I would be helping those people by performing there. Yes, everyone is able to listen to me now. Children, online children, send your feedback. I'm checking because network issues are there today. Fine, good. So after that, because we are about to end this chapter only, so you can say mostly normal people even cannot achieve this much. If suppose somebody is able to play instruments, how many instruments one can play? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, fine. She was the, you can say, the most talented girl who could play thousands of instruments just by feeling the vibrations. So at last, you will say that she achieved more than most people do twice her age. She achieved more than most people do twice her age. It means at a very young and tender age only, she could win many prizes, trophies, name and fame and success. So Evelyn Glennie is a perfect example of what is the lesson or theme of this chapter. Anyone, raise your hand sitting at home, beta. Raise your hand and tell me what is the theme, what lesson do you get from Evelyn Glennie, this chapter, The Sound of Music? What inspiration you get from Evelyn Glennie? Yes, Divya is here. We should not give up in life. We should not give up our hopes in life. Very good. Any other? Lisa? One more point is there which you are missing. We should not? Disabilities do not come to destroy you. It does not mean you are disabled. Disability means you are differently able. Ye likh lo. Disability means you are differently able. Pata hai aapko ye term ab ban ho chuki hai. We are not supposed to call them disabled. Such people who are having any sort of disability, they are not disabled. How can disabled means jo able hi nahi hai. Yes, differently able. They are able, but unka tarika kuch aur hoega. The way Evelyn Glennie proved also. Fine. So she was differently able child. She was not disabled, but the word is used here again and again. That's why we have to use it in the chapter. in our answers also. Otherwise, the term is differently abled children only. Clear? So we have learned this chapter is very inspirational. Theme is based on we should not give up in life. We should work upon our abilities. We should put in constant efforts in our life. We should not stop. Fine, constant effort should be there. So all these things we learn from Evelyn Glenn. Fine. Chaliye, ab next we have time. So we will moving on to, let me ask you some questions first. Part 2 bhi hai, but iske question pooch lu pehle main aapko. MCQs, beta, be ready for this. How did Evelyn Glennie, MCQs now, beta, on based on this part 1. 3-4 we will do. How did Evelyn Glennie's loss of hearing take place? Fine. Yes, Brijesh, pay attention. How did it take place? First, option A. All of a sudden, option B. Within 10 years, option C, hearing was gradual. Option D, she became deaf at the age of 7. Question I'm making on the spot, it is not written in the book even. Tabhi main keh rahi hoon, dhyan se suno. MCQs available nahi hai kahin pe bhi. I myself creating it by reading one of the questions in my book. The question is, how did Evelyn Glennie loss of hearing take place? Kaise uski hearing disability jo start hui thi, kaise hui thi? Fine, even I had to think what options I gave to you. Option A, all of a sudden. Option B, slowly and gradually. Option C, at the age of 7. Or option D, none of the above. Okay. Slowly and gradually. It was not all of a sudden or out of the blue she became fine. Then she was able to listen when she was born. When at the age of 8, she had that her mother, noticed that she's having difficulty in understanding. When she calls her name, she does not respond. Fine. But she became deaf by the age of 8 only. So 8 saal ki age tak wo deaf ho gayi thi and it was a gradual process. स्कूल को कब पता लगा था? दैट वाज एट द एज ऑफ 11. स्कूल अथॉरिटीज को 8 से लेके 11 के बीच में पता ही नहीं चला. क्लियर? सो व्हाई डिडंट दे गेट टू नो? बिकॉज़ शी वाज कंसीलिंग इट, शी वाज हाइडिंग इट द होल फैमिली मे बी. फाइन. फ्रॉम डेफनेस फ्रॉम फ्रेंड्स एंड टीचर्स. एंड व्हेन एट द एज ऑफ 11 उसकी परफॉर्मेंस बहुत पुअर हो गई. व्हेन शी स्टार्टेड परफॉर्मिंग डिटीरियोरेट परफॉर्मेंस, देन दे रियलाइज ओके सम प्रॉब्लम इज देयर. Then they call the parents. Fine. Next is, who spotted the potential of Evelyn Glennie? Percussionist Ron Forbes, her mother, her father, or headmistress at her school? Who discovered? Ron Forbes. This is very clear cut answer. Yes, Riyanshika, well done. She is giving answer in the chat box. So Ron Forbes is the correct answer. Clear? What did Ron Forbes suggest Evelyn? Option A. Percussionist Ron Forbes advised Evelyn, try to listen through ears only. He advised, try to sense it some other way. He advised to beat a drum and feel it. None of the above. Sense and feel it the other way. Aapne kaun sa bola? Yehi wala bola. Theek hai? Second option is the correct answer. Fine. So let's move on to next now. Part 2 is Shanaya Bismillah Khan. यस यू राइट. नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द सेम चैप्टर बेटा वी आर गोइंग टू डू नाउ पार्ट टू द शहनाई ऑफ बिस्मिल्ला खान. नाउ आई विल बी मेकिंग यू राइट अबाउट दिस फाइन. यू डूइंग द साउंड ऑफ म्यूजिक. Part one was Evelyn Glennie. Part two is Bismillah Khan. You should remind, you know, yourself on daily basis. The name of chapters also you have to revise. In case of poems, the name of the poem and poets also. Word meanings also. Vocabulary should be very good. Okay. So we are going to do the Shehnai of Bismillah Khan. We have time. Revision. Bell hone wali, I guess. Other classes joining in between. Okay, I'll give you introduction of this chapter and then we'll continue tomorrow. Fine. Yes, Brijesh, you are not concentrating today at all. So, Shehnai of Bismillah Khan, beta, what is the main theme of this chapter? Actually, Bismillah Khan's life history, if we go through, that we'll just get glimpses of hard work, dedication, and efforts only. So, both the stories are deliberately chosen to be part of Sound of Music. Clear? In the first part, she used to play she became percussionist herself, but in the second part, Bismillah Khan, a Shehnai player, how he became famous. Fine, that is the story, that from an unknown personality to a well-known personality, that he's the part of your CBSE chapters now. Clear? So, Bismillah Khan's life history shows that there is no substitution to hard work and dedication, and people who reached to such heights, jisko kehte hai, zenith of success, the top of success. They do not become successful in one night. These are the efforts since childhood, these are the efforts since adulthood, many years, months, and then they become successful. Fine. So, in this story, we will be reading about a barber, fine, how he decides to improve the quality of a one old instrument known as pungi, fine, all those things, and how that pungi became Shehnai, how Shehnai came into existence, fine. So historical data is there, and then the hard work and efforts of Bismillah Khan, and that we will be reading tomorrow, fine, because time ho chuka hai, so we will continue this tomorrow.